click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, now we are going to discuss about a new topic, that is physical equilibrium and physical process. So what are these two terms that I've been doing in chemical equilibrium? So it is very important to understand that. So let's talk about it. So now let us understand what is actually the physical process. So physical process is the change of a substance from one phase to another phase. So that is what the physical process means. So as the name suggests, that there would be change in the physical phase, or we could say that would be change in the physical state of a particular substance. And for example, the common example that I could explain to you, that is the transformation of the phases that takes place for ice, and that is because ice consists of, basically it is made up of water, that is H2O. So therefore this H2O, which is present in a solid form, that has a capability to convert into that of, that is H2O, which is of liquid phase. And even that is the one that is can be converted into, that is gaseous phase. So if you observe, then in this case the structure, or we could say that the composition of the chemical, that is for H2O, it is not been changing. The only thing that is been changing is the phase or the physical state, and that is from solid to liquid and from liquid to gas. So in this case it has been found that the solid can be transformed into the physical state, that is liquid, but meanwhile the liquid has also the capability to convert into that of the solid phase. So this kind of phase transition, where we could see that the solid has been converted into liquid, so basically this is known as fusion. And again, when the liquid has been converted into solid, that is basically known as freezing. And similarly, we could say that H2, which is present in a liquid form, that could be able to form a gaseous phase, while there will be a physical transition in this case. And basically this kind of process, or the change that occurs, is basically known as vaporization. And what if the gaseous phase is converted into liquid? Basically that is known as condensation. And moreover, we could see even the solid can be converted into the gaseous phase, and that is basically known as sublimation. So in this case, the chemical, it doesn't changes. The only thing is the physical state changes, and this is what the physical process means. And this is what I wanted to explain. But the physical process has been done, and now let us understand what is actually physical equilibrium. So let us understand the definition of it, and we'll move on with the next one. So the equilibrium attained between the two phases of the same substance, when the rate of forward and the reverse changes are equal, then it is called to be physical equilibrium. So physical equilibrium deals with the rate of the change. So in this case, suppose if I would consider like that of the H2O, same that we have did over here, that is H2O is the one which is converting in from solid phase to suppose liquid phase. So it will convert, that is ice can be converted to liquid phase, as well as the liquid water that can be converted into the solid phase of H2O, that is known as ice. So the physical transition, or we could say that the phase transition, is been possible in this thing, as we could see. For example, if H2, which is present in solid, that can be converted into H2, which is liquid. So meanwhile, the liquid can also be converted into solid. For this example, if H2 is converting into liquid and even liquid has been converting into solid, so in this case we will get to know that the physical process has been possible. But when it comes to the physical equilibrium, it depends on the rate. So that's the reason there will be a certain position, or there will be a certain point where we could find that the rate of conversion of a solid phase to liquid phase, as well as from the liquid phase of liquid phase to solid phase, that will be the same. And the position, or the moment where we could find the rate of the forward reaction and the rate of the reverse reaction, there is no reaction, but there is rate of the physical transition that we could say, or the physical state that could change. So in that case, if that has been found to be equal, then that we could say that the system, or that thing, has been acquired equilibrium. And because it is dealing with the physical state of a particular substance, therefore that kind of state is basically known as physical equilibrium, and that is what I have mentioned over here. So that's it. I wanted to explain about the physical equilibrium. Thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have understood this video very clearly, and I hope you will share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.